everyone, Bo here. I make videos and put them on YouTube, and today I'm finally getting around to reacting to some Dream Theater. You've been wanting this for a long time. I have too. It's just about making time. So we're gonna listen to Peruvian Skies. I've never seen this footage before, High Voltage 2011. I'm sure it's been out there for a while. Obviously 6 years, right? Very excited to look at this. I think it's a festival in the UK. I think we're gonna dive right in, ladies and gentlemen. Not too long, not too short. Equip yourselves, here we go.
It says a lot for just the whole genre, for all the bands that are playing. You know, a lot of people that we know and we admire. You know, we've come a long way from the first time we played in London, a real long time ago, to now. So it feels great. Really happy to be here.
I hear it again.
that was stellar. I really, really enjoyed that performance, especially from LaBrie. Because nowadays, you know as well as I do, if you're a Dream Theater fan, that LaBrie just, he's not able to sing the same anymore. It's tough. You know, he has a very difficult job. His voice goes through hell and back on a nightly basis. And he falls flat more often than not, unfortunately. And he tries to overcompensate by putting a lot of vibrato on the tail end of his notes. But it's not fooling anybody, unfortunately. But this isn't the case. 6 years ago in this performance, he really knocked it out. This and Score, I think he sounded really great in Score. And now this. This is actually 2011, Dramatic Turn of Events would have been released. And this is when I saw Dream Theater with Trivium open for him. And it was a hell of a concert. Just, I went home on cloud nine. I think I was high for like a week just from the music itself, I promise. Great times. Right when Portnoy left, they lost Portnoy, or rather Portnoy lost Dream Theater. That's how I put it anyway. And a lot of people had hate for Mike Mangini, and I'll put it out there right now. He's a great drummer. I don't understand. I think that people are just kind of asshurt that Portnoy is not in the band anymore, and they don't like change. They want, you know, the old formation back, and I get it. I love Portnoy. I miss those days, but look, you know, old times. Moving on, we have a very capable, overqualified drummer to do this job, and he sounds exceptional. He accents different things. It was really cool watching them do the different auditions. I was actually rooting for Marco Miniman, but it was really nice to see Marco be in Steven Wilson's band for a little bit and travel and do music with him. So yeah, you'd have to watch that if you haven't already done that. Anyway, I digress. Yeah, Petrucci. He's using, it looks like, maybe his BFR. This is kind of before his, a little bit before his Majesty days. His new guitar is a Majesty, and it has this weird carbon fiber print in the middle of it. And I'm not a fan of the design of it. It sounds splendid, but yeah. This had the DiMarzio Crunch Lab and Liquifier pickups, and his tone is just killer, man. And that solo just sustained for days and cuts right through. Fucking beautiful. I love this. I love this performance so damn much. Yeah, excellent, guys. You have to let me know what you thought. Hopefully you enjoyed this reaction and this song. Let me know what you want to hear, maybe some more Dream Theater. I'll get to the longer songs someday, I promise. And guys, be like what I do, subscribe. We'll see you next time. Bye.